Hi, I'm Carl. Welcome to tonight's episode of Musicians with Guitars Drinking Wine. Tonight we have a special guest from Paris, France, although currently based in London, England. It's Natalie.
Hello.
You said that without any sort of accent whatsoever.
Bonjour.
Natalie will be playing an 1874 Martin 121 model. C.F. Martin started making guitars in 1833, and by the mid-1850s, he was producing several hundred guitars a year. Despite this growth, his ledger book still itemized each instrument's type of wood and ornamentation. Finally, in late 1856, he created a standardized model numbering system. This guitar is a Model 121. In an era when most guitars were 16 to 17 inches long and under 12 inches wide, the Model 1, originally Martin's largest guitar, was a whopping 18 and 7/8 inches long and 12 and 3/4 inches wide. As a Style 21 model, this guitar features highly figured Brazilian rosewood back and sides, delicate rosewood lines around the sound hole and outer binding, and colored wood herringbone patterns around the sound hole and backstripe. Other details include a cedar neck, engraved tuner plates, and ivory tuner buttons. From the 1830s until the end of the century, Martin shipped their guitars in wooden cases, now referred to as coffin cases. This is an 1874 Martin Model 121 with its original coffin case.
She'll be accompanied by John. Hi, John.
Hey, Carl.
Nice to see you again.
Yeah.
John will be playing a 1954 Martin D-18.
Martin reluctantly introduced their super-large model D-18 in 1933. Unlike the balanced tone of the smaller-bodied guitars, the D-18 was bass-heavy, but it was loud and just what the players wanted. It soon became Martin's best-selling guitar. As a Style 18, it was a fairly bare-bones guitar with mahogany back and sides, tortoiseshell celluloid binding, a simple black backstripe, and an unbound fingerboard. But what it lacked in decoration, it made up for in volume. And as you can see in this guitar, durability. This is a 1954 Martin D-18.
And tonight, we'll be drinking
Chateau de Bayeux-Cancar.
How do you like the guitar so far?
Yeah, it's really nice, but it's a bit small, isn't it?
It seems that way by today's standards. But in its day, it was the big size. In fact, they called this large in 1874. Martin's numbering system is rather interesting. The first number refers to the size of the guitar, and the second number, its level of ornamentation. So this is a 121. 1 meaning it was the large size guitar, and 21 its level of fanciness.
Oh, yeah. I noticed that the wood was very, very detailed.
This is Brazilian rosewood. You can't buy that anymore.
Is anything else about this guitar illegal?
And not everything else is, oh, well, you know, actually, the machine head buttons are ivory, so they're probably not legal either anymore. When C.F. Martin invented this guitar, it was his main size, so he called it the size 1. And then he thought, well, we're going to have smaller sizes, so the smaller sizes were 2 and 3, all the way down to like 5 was a very small guitar. But then in the 1860s, he said, well, some people wanted a slightly bigger guitar. And it already backed himself into a corner numbering-wise, so he had to make his bigger guitar a 0.
A 0.
So until 1890, the 0 was the biggest guitar, and then they wanted an even bigger guitar, so you had to make it a 00. Mm-hmm. And oddly, nowadays we call those a 00 or a 000 Martin guitar, but truly it's 0. So it really is a size 0, size 00, size 000.
Is it 000?
Yeah.
What's this?
Well, that's a dreadnought size. Would you like to hear the story behind that?
Sure.
From the beginning, Martin made guitars for other companies. So if you had a publishing house or if you were even a teacher, they would make guitars for you. So in 1916, this company, this publishing house out of Boston named Ditson, wanted to have the biggest guitar in the world. So they were buying guitars from Martin, so they asked Martin to design this guitar, which was so huge that Martin called it the bass guitar. Because it was just, they couldn't believe somebody would want a guitar that big. And they called it the dreadnought size. That was the name of a British battleship. In 1931, Ditson went out of business. So Martin had that size made, so they decided to start slowly introducing that size guitar, the Dreadnought size, into their line. This guitar over there, as you can see, the previous owner played both kinds of music, country and Western. But the point is, in the 1800s, this was considered a big guitar. So this is the size 1, and its ornamentation is a 21. You have a band in London.
I do.
Called More Ice and Honey.
Correct. They're Finnish and French and, what are they, Czech and Russian and Belgian and English. Very international band.
So what you're saying is that music is universal.
It is. Our people. Common language is music. They don't actually speak English, which is a lie. They do.
Even if the musicians in your band did not speak English, they could still play the songs.
No. I wish it were true, but no.
I thought we just said music was universal.
Yeah, but you still have to explain chords and structure and stuff.
Do different languages have different names for the chords?
Yeah, in French we still use the do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Instead of calling them A, B, C, D, F, G, we call them do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Like in that song from Sound of Music.
Do, a dear.
Well, give me an example of how you would explain something to someone using do, re, mi.
Well, this is a do chord.
Oh, a C. Mm-hmm. It's a do chord. Yeah. I never knew that. Did you know that?
Well, it starts on C and just goes up to the next C. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do.
I've learned something new here today. That the sound of music is important. Let's say you had a French rock musician, a French garage band. Les Garage El Bando. Would they say the chords of the song are G, C, and D?
Probably, because of the internet and everything. When you look up like a popular song on like Ultimate Guitar, it'll be in G, C, D.
So then we don't need the sound of music anymore.
Well, it's always good to know stuff.
The sound of music will always be there for us.
It will.
Yes. Well, then let's try your song for this evening. Okay. And accompany you on background singing the song. Not only will be John playing the 1954 D-18, but from London, England, Max.
Mm-hmm.
Chirping outside, I can hear winds blowing the sky, but the only thing missing here is you. But the only thing missing here
Wow, it looks like a coffin.
That's exactly what they call it. They call these coffin cases.
It looks like
wonder.
It. Well, and that thought, was not rehearsed.
I never thought it looked like a coffin.
Awesome.
Yeah, somebody with a real long neck.
Well, yeah, obviously a guitar coffin.